Paula. So today I'm here with a very quick message, okay? And it is okay to fail, okay? And I know many of you may have heard this before, but I'm here to truly tell you that it is okay. It is okay to fail. And see, the thing is sometimes we don't feel like it's okay to fail because people don't usually broadcast their failures, okay? Whether it's big or small, people don't usually broadcast their failures. They don't usually talk about, you know, different encounters or, you know, different things that happen while they are on a journey to getting somewhere, okay? And sometimes we beat ourselves up because of failures. We beat ourselves up on the road to getting what we want, or even sometimes we decide to quit. Sometimes we want to give up when we are on the road to accomplishing something. And I think just knowing that everyone has failed before, it makes you, you know, feel better. It makes you feel more comfortable in knowing that it is okay to fail, okay? The only thing that matters is if you decide to get back up or sit down in that failure. That's the only thing that matters, because we all fail. We all fail at something, whether it's big or small, whether it's a big goal or whether it's something that's small, okay? We all fail at something. We may all fail at something that may seem as if it's so simple to do. If we just watch someone else do it, it may seem as if it's just so simple to do, but once we put our hands in it and we try to do it, we fail at it. But there's no need in beating ourselves up with it. So I'm going to give you something that happened to me yesterday. So yesterday I tried to do an activity with my sister. So someone had told me about making these cookie bowls, okay? You basically just get a muffin pan. Well, the person told me to just get a muffin pan and that they shape the cookie dough up as if it was like a bowl. They put it in the oven and then they put ice cream scoops inside the bowls, okay? So I'm like, okay, this sounds so simple. Like, how difficult could that be? So I did the exact same thing. Me and my sister, we got the muffin pan. We put the cookie dough inside of the muffin and we stretched the cookie dough out within each section to make it look like a bowl. And we put it inside the oven. I'm like, wow, like I'm peeking inside the oven. I'm like, okay, this is taking forever. This is taking forever to do. I'm like, okay, maybe I just need to be patient. I'm like, okay, a few more minutes went by. I'm like, okay, no. This should have been done. Got a fork, stuck a fork in it, and it's like the cookie dough on the inside, it still was not finished. I'm like, okay, yeah, this is a failed experiment. At this point, I'm kind of getting frustrated, but I'm like, okay, I got more cookie dough left. You know, thank God I had some left just in case I failed, okay? So we're gonna fix this. So I looked it up online. I saw pictures online where people, they actually turned the muffin pan upside down. And they actually put the cookie dough on the back of the muffin pan, okay? They put the cookie dough on the back of the muffin pan, so therefore the holes would already be created and you stick it inside of the oven, you know? We won't have to create the holes ourselves this time. So me and my sister, we took our time and we did this. So a few minutes later, I happened to peek inside the oven. It's like the dough spread it amongst the whole back of the pan. Okay, it did not look pretty at all. So I'm like, okay, maybe we can make this work. Maybe I can cut off the excess dough. Okay, so took the pan out of the oven and tried to cut around it. And it's like the cookie dough, it was just hardened. And so I'm like, okay, I'm just, you know what, forget it. At this point, I'm angry. I'm angry and I'm frustrated. And I'm mad because it's like I had a taste for this. I had a taste for the cookies and the ice cream, and the experiment failed not only once but twice. Okay, so then I tried to scrape the cookies off of the pan and it's like it just would not come off the pan. So I'm like, okay, well, wow, I just bought a new pan for nothing, and now I won't be able to use this pan ever again, even if I did decide to do another experiment with it tonight, it's not gonna work because the cookies has hardened on all on the pan, and it's hard for me to scrape the cookies off. So I threw the entire pan in the trash. So not only am I upset and frustrated because I don't have this cookie bowl that I had been craving, but I'm also frustrated because I spent money on the ingredients. I spent money on the pan. And it's like I'm throwing all of this in the trash. And last but not least, what I was mostly frustrated about was the fact that I failed. I was upset at the fact that I failed at this experiment that looked to be so easy. I looked at pictures of it. I heard someone else tell me how they did it. It seemed all so easy, but I failed. Sometimes when we fall down, when we fail at something, different thoughts begin to run across our mind. Thoughts that aren't always necessarily true. So one of the thoughts that came across my mind was like, girl, you probably failed at it because you don't know how to cook no cookies. So now I'm sitting there angry and I'm processing this thought that was in my mind. And I'm getting upset because this seemed all too easy. It looked all too easy for me to be failing at it. So then my sister said to me, I'm standing there quietly and I'm just, you know, cleaning up after myself. Even as I was tilting the pan and the trash can, the cookies, it just crumbled and bits of it just fell all on the floor. Bits of it fell all on the stove. It was a mess. So while I'm standing there, I'm cleaning up the crumbs and I'm processing all of this within my mind. My sister, she said to me, she said, you don't have to be upset about it. You don't have to cry. And I said to her, I said, I'm not crying. And the thing is, you know, I wasn't crying, but I was upset. And she sensed that I was upset, even though, you know, I didn't say too much about it. Or at least I don't remember whether I said too much about it. She sensed that I was upset. And she reassured me, you know, that it's okay. She reassured me, like, you know, you don't have to cry about it. And she said to me, she said, well, we still have the ice cream. And that's the thing. I want us to remember this. When we fall, you know, don't stay down for too long. Okay, no matter what the situation is. When you fall, when you fail at something, don't stay down there for so long because you always learn a lesson. You always learn a lesson. And it seems as if as soon as, you know, after my sister finished speaking to me and she reassured me that I was okay after failing this experiment. Okay? As I'm washing the dishes, I heard a voice that said, it's okay to fail. It's okay to fail. I heard a voice so powerful and so strong that said, it's okay to fail. And I immediately knew that I had to bring this to y'all and let y'all know that it's okay. It's okay to fail. Okay? She said to me, she said, at least you have the ice cream. And that's the thing. At least you have the lesson. At least you have the lesson after failing. At least you have the lesson. Even if it's hard to grasp it at the moment. Even if it's hard to figure out why you went through that. Even if it's hard to figure out why you failed at something that appeared and seemed to be so easy. You still have the lesson. Okay? And when those negative thoughts enter your mind regarding your failure, like that thought that entered in my mind that said, you probably don't know how to bake no cookies anyway, that's probably why you failed. When that thought entered my mind, and it entered my mind out of nowhere, nothing but the enemy. So when those thoughts enter your mind and try to tell you why you failed at something, I need you to X that thought out and tell yourself, you know what? Smile at the situation. Laugh at it if you have to. It's okay to fail. I'm going to get back up and I'm going to try it again. Okay? The only failing, it doesn't even matter if you fail. The only thing that matters is what you do after you fail. The only thing that matters is if you decide to get right back up after that failure. Okay? So I thank you all so much for watching. I love y'all so much. Bye.